First, we'll use LoggerNet's easy setup wizard to set up communications between the computer and the CR300. From the main category of the LoggerNet toolbar, select Setup. This is the easy or simplified setup view. If your screen looks something like this, with more buttons at the top, you are in the standard view. To toggle to the easy view, select View and Easy or Simplified. Start the wizard by clicking the Add button here. The Easy Setup wizard opens and by following the steps on the screen, we'll set up the communications between our computer and data logger. Click Next. Select the type of data logger you'll be connecting to. Scroll down and choose the CR300 series. It's a good idea to give it a meaningful name, such as a site identifier or a project name. Next. These are the connection types supported by the Easy Setup Wizard. We'll be connecting our computer to the CR300 with a USB cable. Select Direct Connect and click Next. Because this is the first time we'll be connecting to a CR300, we need to install the driver. Select CR300 series. Click Install. If you don't see this wizard, take a look at the buttons in your Windows taskbar. There may be a program requesting permission to proceed. Click through the wizard, accepting the defaults, and finish. For this tutorial, we'll be using the USB cable for communications, so I'll plug it in here and to my computer here. The USB cable also provides temporary power to the CR300. For field deployment, you'll need a 12-volt battery. The power LED indicates the program and the power state of the CR300. Because the CR300 ships with a program set to run on power-up, the power LED will quickly flash 3 times every 10 seconds when powered over USB. When powered with a 12-volt battery, it flashes once every 10 seconds. Once the drivers are installed and the CR300 connected to the computer, select the drop-down arrow, and the COM port will show up as CR300 COM. Mine is COM 8. Your COM port may have a different number. Next. We'll leave these settings as their defaults. All data loggers leave the factory with a packbus address of 1. If yours has been changed, you will need to enter its address here. Next. We aren't going to set security today. Next. Here's a summary. Next. Let's test our communications now. Next. Success. If you are not successful, check, is your computer cable connected to the data logger? Disconnect the cable from your computer and plug it back in. Did you select the correct COM port? What is the data logger's packbus address? Sync your CR300's clock to the computer here. Next. Here we see the name of the program that is currently running. Quickstart is the program that ships in a new CR300. Next. This screen shows the stored data tables that will be collected during either manual or scheduled data collection. The tables with a green check will be included. By default, all the tables defined in your program are included for collection. The tables with a red X are not collected. We'll keep all the defaults. Click Next. We're not setting up scheduled collection today. Click Next and finish. Here's a summary. If you need to make changes to the setup, relaunch the wizard by clicking the Edit button. We're done setting up communication. Close the Easy Setup screen. Next, we'll go to LoggerNet's Connect screen to look at the example program's live measurement values. From the main category of the LoggerNet toolbar, click Connect. Once your station is set up, this is where you'll spend most of your time. Select which station to connect to. This list can get long once your network of data loggers grows. Connect. Now let's use the table monitor to view real-time data. Choose the public table because that is where our measurement values are updated every program scan, once a second in the Quick Start program. Each data record has a number as shown here. The next field is the timestamp of the data. Our Quick Start program takes 2 measurements, the processing board's temperature labeled PTEMP and the battery voltage. When powered by USB, the battery voltage shows up as 0. That's to remind you that you need a 12-volt battery for field deployment. Click Disconnect to end the session. We'll talk more about the features of the Connect screen later in this tutorial series after we create a new program and send it to our CR300.